Control commands are one of the most useful features. You can use them to directly control a window by clicking buttons, setting text and other things. It's usually more reliable and should work with windows in the background too. You can use it to modify a control, enable or disable it, move it, hide it, etc. And also retrieve information like the items from the list view, for example. For this demonstration, I'm going to use 7-zip file manager. We're going to access the options window and make some changes. Let's add a run command and WinWait to make sure the window is open. You don't need WinWaitActive in this case because we'll not send normal clicks or keystrokes. There doesn't seem to be a shortcut to access the options, so let's use another command. Copy the window class from WinWait command and open the Run command window. From the Run window command list, select Win menu select item. In Win title, paste the window class. In menu, type the name of the main menu you want to access, which is Tools in this case. The submenu is Options. You can omit the three dots. Uncheck the previous commands and run a test. Notice that WinMenu select item will not work with non-standard menus such as the ones from Internet Explorer. Add another WinWait for the Options window. In the first tab, we'll use Ctrl-click to click on the Select All button. Select the mouse command and check Control option. Click on the Get button and place the cursor over the control. Right-click to get the control name. Notice that this will automatically retrieve the Windows class to save you some time and clicks. If coordinates are blank, it will click at the center of the control. Now go to the Control commands. We use the Control command and the Tab Right subcommand. Click on the Get button and place the cursor over the tab's control. Press the right button, now click OK. Uncheck rows 1 to 4 and run the macro to test it. On this tab, we're going to uncheck the last two options. This is a list view control, so we cannot use the uncheck command. Let's use a control click instead. This time, we'll set the coordinates to the checkbox we want to click. Duplicate the command and get the coordinates for the last checkbox. Duplicate the tab right command. In this tab, we use the check command to select the third option. Insert another control command, select the control set text from the list, get the name of the folder field. In the value field, type the path for the folder. Duplicate the tab right command again. This time we want to skip the next tab, so edit the command and add a true to the value field. Let's use the check command again to mark the first and fifth row in this tab. To finish, add a control click to the OK button. I'll close the window without saving the changes and close the program. Check all rows again and run the macro. Going to the options, you can see that all commands have worked. Those are the principles to automate common Windows commands. Notice that control will not work on browsers and programs that use non-standard controls.